Tonight on Inspectors, rotting rat carcasses and dead pigeons and leftover food.
It's absolutely disgusting.
Also illegal camping in a city park, high, homeless and busted.
Good morning. Wakey wakey, good morning.
And on the hunt for the nasty rotter who dumped this stinking rubbish. Auckland Council's Environmental Health Inspector Paula Cameron is investigating a complaint about rats in central Auckland.
10 minutes ago when I was looking, a little rat just came and walked along this piece of wood. So they're running about in this backyard. You can hear it.
The first thing Paula needs to do is look at the yard behind the fence where the rats are breeding.
So this is the bins down here. There's a lot of rubbish around the bin, so they could be feeding on the rubbish that's lying around the bin.
The yard is shared between the butcher and the supermarket next door. Paula goes to talk to the butcher first.
We've had a complaint from one of the neighbours about rats.
Rats?
Yeah, in the yard. Do you know about this?
No, because the rats, it's actually to next door shops.
Okay.
Because they're a spice shop.
Yeah.
And a lot of things. Red doesn't eat meat.
Oh, they do eat meat.
She shows the butcher where the rats are feasting, but he's still adamant it's nothing to do with him.
So it looks like the problem areas are actually next door, so what I'll need to do is speak to next door about the general mess of their yard, this area.
Before Paula goes next door to the supermarket, she has a closer look around. The most obvious sign of a rat infestation is the presence of dead rats. If she finds one, then it's likely there is a full-blown infestation.
I'll pull it out. There we go. One dead rat.
This is bad news. Rats carry a large variety of diseases. The worst is hantavirus, which can lead to kidney, liver, and heart failure. It's transmitted to humans by inhaling airborne particles from rodent droppings.
Oh, there's droppings. So you can see there the rat droppings there. And there's more rat droppings over here. So there's so much rubbish and food under here and places to hide. It's nice and dark. It's perfect for rats.
And it doesn't take long to find out where they are nesting.
You see the holes here? This is the rat burrows. So this is where they're burrowing underneath. They may have some nests down here. Rats can squeeze through the smallest of spaces, so this is actually quite a big entry point for them.
Then something catches Paula's attention in the fridge in the supermarket yard.
There's rat droppings there. Oh, there's bird droppings as well. Oh, nice, I think we've got a dead bird. So. Oh, yeah, nice.
Not just a bird, but two dead pigeons squashed between the rice bags.
Oh, I think they're dead. I hope they're dead. This is obviously not good. I'm going to have to go in and speak to the owner and find out what on earth's going on here. So that's a first for me. In my 15 years as an EHO, I have never seen two dead birds in a dry store with some rice. It's absolutely disgusting.
Dead or alive, pigeons carry a cocktail of nasty, fatal, airborne and parasitic diseases. The worst is histoplasmosis, which is so potent it was once considered as a biological warfare agent. It infects the blood and can cause major organ damage and death. Find out later when Paula confronts the owner of the supermarket. On the city's North Shore, Auckland Council's bylaws officer Malcolm Denmead is on a call out to investigate a tent illegally erected in a local reserve.
We don't know where they're going to the toilet, what they're up to, why are they here, and all the rubbish they leave behind. People are a bit anti this, particularly in a lovely park like this.
Because the people inside the tent are sleeping, Malcolm has a look around. He finds toilet paper in the bush, rubbish, and even worse, drug paraphernalia. It's time to wake them up and find out what's going on.
Good morning. Good morning. Wakey, wakey. Good morning.
Hi.
Hi. Who's the boss here?
Huh?
It's opening, okay.
The campers appear to be passed out and are very groggy when woken up.
He's dead, isn't he? Is he alive?
Yeah. Malcolm tries to find out what they are doing here.
Any reason why you're actually here at all? Is there a reason? Can we help you in any way? Look, I'm Malcolm from the council in Takapuna. You've got to move off out of here, okay? Is that where your plans are? To move off or what? What's going on?
Yeah, we're just resting for now, bro. We're going to move off later.
Are you? Today? Okay, what time do you reckon you'll be out of here? Sorry?
Whenever we wake up.
Malcolm gives them a warning about their rubbish.
Is this all your rubbish too, around here? All your eating, all your fish, you're enjoying some fish or whatever you've got here?
No, that was already here.
That was already here? All right. I mean, you've got a perfect spot here, but you can't camp here at all. All right. We don't want to take your gear away. That's what it boils down to.
Malcolm's been as nice as he can, but judging from the bong and the state of the campers, it looks unlikely they'll listen.
If they don't move, then I'll get the police involved.
It's later in the afternoon, and surprise, surprise, the campers are still there, and it looks like they are huffing glue.
It's just after 4 o'clock. I've just peeked around a tree, and I can see them. The tent's still there, and a bicycle on the grass, so maybe there's more than the three that were there this morning.
At this point, Malcolm calls on the police to help him.
They've been there for a few days now. I don't know where they're toileting or anything, because they have a lot of rubbish around there, and I've watched them come go and get food, so it looks like they're prepared to stay.
Next, the police and Malcolm prepare to take action. Coming up, Paula finds more rotting rat carcasses to show the supermarket owner.
There's another dead one. This one's a bit fresher.
And will the Freedom campers move on, or are they too high to go anywhere?
What are you guys been smoking?
Robert Menzies from Auckland Council is heading out to patrol a road in rural West Auckland that is a hot spot for illegal rubbish dumping.
We have some excellent residents in this part of the street where primarily when they go walking with their animals on, they'll carry some stickers and they'll actually flag a location for us to investigate. We find that this road has been the target of two sorts of dumpers. We have a commercial dumper out there, the sort of guy who'll advertise in the local paper, somebody will contact him, and he'll be given a bit of cash to dispose of the rubbish, but he'll pocket the cash and dispose of the rubbish in this sort of locality. Other scenarios are often tenants moving, and they'll just take their rubbish with them and turf it down the side of the road. In fact, previous investigations have revealed the addresses, which are basically, we trace back to an empty property.
And it isn't long till Robert spots his first indicator.
As you can see, this is some rubbish that's been dumped down the bank in a bit of a tricky and awkward spot. If it's safe to do so, I'll open it up on site.
It's a dirty job, but if Robert finds any evidence, such as letters or bills, he'll be able to track the dumpers down and find them.
In this particular dumping, there is a bit of correspondence from an address, which I find quite strange for it to come from. So we'll pay this person a bit of a visit, a knock on the door, and see what explanation, if any, he can provide. The sort of people who do this are the ones who are just basically lazy, think they're taking the short, cheap route. But of course, that's certainly no defence as far as the court system or the infringement process is concerned. The name on the medicine bottle matches the surname that's on the letter.
Armed with the letter and an address, Robert photographs the rubbish and heads off to find the person responsible for it. They'll be looking at a $250 fine. Auckland ratepayers pay out over $900,000 a year to clear up illegal dumpings of rubbish. Robert has arrived at the address on the letter he found.
We're going to knock on the door, hopefully speak to somebody and try and determine why he's deposited his rubbish or how his rubbish got to be deposited at an address out in Yellish Road.
It looks like the house is being renovated, which may explain some of the rubbish.
He's moved out. Any idea where he may have gone? Or not expecting you to, but I can speak to the landlord, of course.
The builder is able to give Robert the owner's phone number.
We've discovered that the property has recently been vacated by tenants, which strongly lead us to believe that, yes, he's done a bit of a dumping of rubbish before he goes. I'm confident in this case it's not the landlord. It is certainly the tenant. So now we'll approach the landlord to simply determine where the tenant may have gone. I understand there's still property of the tenants on the property, so there's a strong likelihood that he'll be wanting to come back. So there's a strong possibility that we can find out who he is and where he's gone to.
Robert calls the landlord, hoping that she has a forwarding address.
This is Robert Menzies from the Auckland Council.
Robert briefs the landlord on the situation.
I've just spoken to the landlord. She has been very cooperative, and she's quite prepared to supply us a forwarding address for these tenants. So we'll wait until we get a response and go from there.
Back at the transfer station, Robert sends the landlord an email, and for now, it's a waiting game. Later on the inspectors, will Robert track down the dumpers and find out why they did it? Auckland Council's Environmental Health Officer Paula Cameron is investigating an infestation of rats in the backyard of a supermarket. She's also found two dead pigeons squashed amongst a pile of bags of discarded rice.
It's absolutely disgusting. No wonder we've got rats.
Because rats and pigeons carry potentially fatal diseases like salmonella, Paula's urgently got to track down the owners of the yard. The supermarket staff seem intent on clowning around and are obviously unaware of the disgusting state of their yard, but Paula's got to press on with her investigation.
We've had a complaint about rats in the general area. Do you know about, have you seen anything or? No, nothing.
10 minutes later, the boss turns up and Paula shows him one of the dead rats.
There's rats all over here.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
They're jumping over the fence.
Oh.
Yeah, they're in. Do you want me? I need to show you some things.
Okay.
This is a mess.
The owner tells Paula he has started to clean up, but she tells him it's not good enough and he needs to get a move on.
It needs to go this week. Yeah. Everything needs to go. Look at this. No wonder you've got rats.
Put in the bin. It will go in the bin.
Yeah.
The owner then picks the dead rat up with his bare hands. He obviously doesn't realise he's exposing himself to a major health hazard. Rats carry several nasty viruses. Lymphocytic chorioamnionitis is a viral infection transmitted through saliva and urine of rats. It results in fever, headache, nausea and vomiting.
All of this needs to go, because what they're doing is they're hiding here, they're breeding, they're eating the food.
And she also wants to ask him about the other discovery she made in the fridge.
I need to show you this. This is terrible. Look.
The
owner seems unconcerned about the birds and doesn't have an answer. But he tells Paula he'll have it all cleared up by tonight.
Tonight is bin going, this bin? Yeah. All will go in.
So it's all going?
All going, this rubbish bin.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then she shows him where the rats are nesting and insists he contact pest control immediately.
This is where the rats are living. Do you see this is their burrows?
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay.
They're going under here, yeah. Under here. Pest control need to put poison down here.
Next, Paula wants to see if the rats have gnawed their way into the container.
I just need to have a wee look to see that the rats aren't getting in. I think I've found a dead mouse. All right. False alarm. Yay.
Although it turns out to be a leaf, the place is still filthy.
See, you've got ants. Yeah, you need to clean your floor, don't you?
Yeah.
Outside, she spots another nasty specimen.
She's another dead one. This one's a bit fresher.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah. That's the problem. They're all over the place. Yeah. I've seen young ones. I've seen older ones, so they're breeding.
Dead rats and birds are particularly worrying near a food source because they can contaminate food with viruses guaranteed to make you sick. Paula gives the owners 1 week to clean this mess up.
I'll come back next Wednesday.
Right, okay.
I need to see a report from pest control.
Oh, sure.
Tell him to leave me a report,
yeah.
And I'll see what he's been up to.
Do that.
Find out later whether the owners can get this vermin-ridden yard ship shape. Coming up, after pest control and a big cleanup, Paula finds yet another rotting carcass. And freedom campers in the city, high and homeless.
So what are you sniffing glue?
That just makes it.
Robert Menzies from Auckland Council has been trying to track down the owners of a lot of rubbish that was dumped illegally on a road in rural West Auckland. He's found evidence that points to an address. Robert's emailed the suspect's landlord for a forwarding address, but hasn't heard back.
Through a bit of detective work, we managed to locate a current and up-to-date address. Basically, I show them the photograph that was taken, together with the actual physical evidence that I'll have with me.
Time for Robert to confront the alleged litterer and find out what they have to say for themselves.
Are you able to offer me an explanation as to how that rubbish got there?
Where?
Specifically in a road called Yalish Road, which is off Birdwood Road in Massey.
I don't know, I think it's my husband. I don't...
Okay.
But the husband isn't home and won't be there until after work. But that's not going to stop Robert. Robert is back at the apartment. Hopefully he'll be able to speak with the man he suspects is responsible for the illegal dumping. He's invited inside, but the camera isn't.
I'm now somewhat obligated to advise you what's going to happen next. And with regards to the council will be issuing you with an infringement notice, which carries a fee of $250.
A clear admission from the husband that he did it, and Robert's job is done.
That went well as far as council's concerned. The gentleman concerned has acknowledged or has admitted the offence, and as a result of that, he'll be receiving an infringement notice in the mail to the tune of $250. Very much an opportunist dumping, in that he couldn't afford to buy a rubbish bag that week, and he saw or was aware of the location being a place where people have dumped their rubbish in the past. So very much a hotspot, council patrols it, and he's been caught out with regards to dumping rubbish.
Auckland Council's bylaws officer, Malcolm Denmead, has called in the police to help him remove a group of people camping illegally in a city park.
How are you? You were asleep this morning when I spoke to you, but I spoke to this young lady. Hi.
Hi.
I asked you to go. Okay, you haven't. I brought the police down to help me.
The man seems to be holding on to his bag in a suspicious manner, so the policeman decides to investigate.
What's that? I just passed it back, sir. Some glue, sir.
Oh, yeah. Zoys, snuff and glue?
Nah, just me, sir.
Oh, yeah.
And there's more.
What have you guys been smoking?
Legal.
What's that?
Legal.
Legal, honey.
They have been smoking synthetic cannabis.
Just what people want in their park, see? Glue sniffing and drug smoking. Beautiful. Good on you.
They get a telling off and explain their situation.
Where do you not quite normally live?
We don't live anywhere.
Sorry, man.
We don't have a house. We're homeless.
And where are you going to go from here?
I have no idea.
Homeless numbers in Auckland have exploded. It's estimated on any given night there are between 80 to 120 rough sleepers, and that's just in the CBD. They slowly start packing up and get a warning too.
So just be aware if we catch you again, any one of you, and you're in possession of drugs, glue, whatever, you know, okay, behaviour offences.
And the police officer can't resist making a joke about their clothing.
We're off to Bosnia.
But before they leave, the police make them clean up the campsite.
At the very least, you can leave it tidy, eh?
It's a habitual problem Malcolm's keen to get rid of.
Yes, we've got people living in our reserves and cemeteries, vehicles, and we just deal with them as best as we can. We'll see them again probably somewhere on the shore.
So, with the threat of arrest looming, the campers take off, hoping to find another place to call home. Back in the city, Auckland Council's Environmental Health Inspector Paula Cameron is revisiting a dirty supermarket yard which has been overrun with rats. She's given the owners a week to clear the mess up and get the pest problem under control.
They've done quite a good job. They contacted a pest control company. So you can see the rubbish bin is full, but this is debris that they've cleaned up from all of the yard area. So once this is empty, it should be okay. They've removed the fridge that had the dead birds in it, so that's good. And the burrows have been filled in. Hopefully they've put poison down that to kill the rats as well.
Everything looks amazing until Paula finds a rotting carcass.
We've got a dead rat here, so they've missed one. This has been here for a long time, so I think they've just missed this when they've been cleaning. So you can see it's really decomposed.
As Paul is doing this, the owner turns up with a pest control manual.
Yeah, I see you've got your...
Yeah, he done everything.
Your bait boxes. Yeah. Got rodent control stations. Yeah. He's put down poison.
Yeah.
He's put down gel. He's put traps.
Mm.
That's good. There's still some rubbish along here.
Yeah, that will come out.
Okay.
Just as Paul is arranging another on-site visit, the neighbour who originally reported the rat problem shouts over the fence, saying the rats are still scurrying into her garden.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, it's Paula.
There's rats running around all morning.
Well, somebody's telling me the rats are still here.
Yeah.
I wouldn't expect them all to be gone. It's going to take a little while to work, and you've only had a week.
Yeah.
It normally takes 3 weekly visits from a pest control company to get on top of a bad infestation like this, and Paula impresses on the owner to clear the rest of the junk so the rats move on.
They'll go somewhere else.
Then you go somewhere else too.
Well, I'll go somewhere else as well and you'll get rid of me. So there's your ultimate goal. Get rid of the rats and I'll disappear with them.
Next week on Inspectors, the filthy restaurant that's guaranteed to put you off your grub.
I think it's a cockroach. It's absolutely disgusting.
Also, dangerous dogs and Thames. Who killed Ginger?
That's definitely a dog attack. 3 good-sized holes.
And the naughty, ill-equipped fisherman caught red-handed.
Have you both got a life jacket?
Yeah.
No life jacket today.
Pardon?
No.
No life jacket?
Yeah. No life jacket today.